Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope you all are doing good. I am Komal Kabashekhawat and in this video, I am going to discuss the topic autocorrelation. Specifically, I will be discussing how to detect autocorrelation in ebooks. Please watch this video till end because in the entire video, I will be explaining what is autocorrelation, why autocorrelation is a problem, how to detect autocorrelation in ebooks, and how we can solve the problem of autocorrelation. So let's start with it. So what is autocorrelation? Autocorrelation is also called as serial correlation. It refers to a phenomenon where the random error term of one observation is related to random error term of some another observation. So such situation is referred as autocorrelation in econometrics. There can be a positive autocorrelation, a situation of negative autocorrelation, or no autocorrelation. Positive and negative autocorrelation can be depicted graphically as shown here. So the above two figures corresponding to positive autocorrelation shows the case of positive autocorrelation. So it refers to a situation when the random error terms of a particular time period shows the same sign and trend as that of the past values. Okay, so as you can see in the first figure corresponding to positive autocorrelation, if the values are concentrated in the first and third quadrant, then it depicts the situation of a positive autocorrelation case. And the second figure corresponding to positive autocorrelation shows that if the positive values followed by the negative values and then followed by the positive values, so such kind of figure graphically shows the positive autocorrelation case. The lower figure shows the negative autocorrelation case. So in that case, if your values are concentrated in the second and fourth quadrant, it refers to a situation of negative autocorrelation, or graphically it can be also shown as that in figure B, wherein a positive value is followed by negative, then positive, then negative. So such phenomena also refers to a negative autocorrelation case. So in case of autocorrelation, the OLS estimators are linear and unbiased, but they are not efficient. Means they do not fulfill the Bloom properties, that is best linear unbiased estimators. Moreover, the estimated variance of the error term and that of the OLS estimators are biased and they underestimate the true variances. And as a result, the value of R squared, confidence intervals and hypothesis testing is unreliable and provide with wrong or insignificant conclusions, and ultimately the forecasts are also unreliable. So in that case, there is a need to detect whether there is a presence of autocorrelation in your model or not. Now, we can detect autocorrelation through various methods. There is Durbin-Watson test, Durbin's H test, Bruch-Goldfried LM test, serial correlation LM test. Okay, so you can use any one of these tests to detect autocorrelation. Now, the null hypothesis in case of autocorrelation is that H0 states that there is no autocorrelation, whereas the alternative hypothesis states that there is a presence of autocorrelation in the model. Now, the thumb rule in case of these methods is same. That is, if the probability value is less than the 5% level of significance, in that case, we reject the null hypothesis. So, if p-value is less than 0.05, we reject H0. That is, there is a presence of autocorrelation in the model. Now, Durbin-Watson statistics can also be used to detect at first glance whether there is a presence of autocorrelation or not in the model. So in case of Durbin-Watson statistics, the range of the statistics is from 0 to 4. As you can see, these ranges have been drawn from 0 to 4. So the Durbin-Watson statistics is close to 0, then in that case, there is positive autocorrelation. Okay, so we reject H0 if the statistics value is close to somewhere 0. And if it is close to 0, then we do not reject H0. It means there is no autocorrelation in the model. And if the Durbin-Watson statistics is close to 4, then in that case, there is a presence of negative autocorrelation. So alternatively, the null hypothesis is sometimes also stated as presence of no autocorrelation, and the alternative is stated as presence of positive autocorrelation or presence of negative autocorrelation. To summarize, alright. So the next question is how to remove autocorrelation. There are various methods available in literature. Like you can use generalized least squared method, Preys-Winston transformation. So basically, the model is transformed by taking logs, or you can transform some of the variables if possible. So some kind of transformation also helps to remove the problem of autocorrelation. Then there is first difference method, Cochrane-Orkutch method, and Durbin's two-step method. Okay, so let's start with it. So first of all, open your eViews and import your data file for which you want to detect whether there is autocorrelation or not in the model. So suppose this is my data file which I have already imported, and I'll select all the variables to detect whether there is a presence of autocorrelation or not in the model. So first select your dependent variable followed by all the independent variables that you are using in your model, okay? And then open these as equation. So for checking autocorrelation, we need to first run simple regression with the data set. So as you can see in the dialog box, the first variable is the dependent variable and the next three are the independent variables in the model, and C here is for the constant. Now click OK to run the simple regression. Now here you can see in the results, variables are mentioned, coefficient is mentioned, standard error, t statistics and probability values. Okay. Now here, the Durbin-Watson statistics is also mentioned, which is 1.37. So this value is somewhere close to 2 and it is also between 0 and 2. So we can't completely like figure out with the Durbin-Watson statistics alone whether there is a presence of autocorrelation or not. So to ensure this, I will be using LM serial correlation test. So for that, go to View, Residual Diagnostics, and select serial correlation LM test. Here, you need to select the legs as per the demand of the model. So here, 2 is already selected. So I'll proceed with that. Now click OK. So these are the results for Bruch-Goldfried serial correlation LM test. Here, the probability value corresponding to F statistics is 0.03. It is less than 0.05. So in that case, we reject our null hypothesis and there is a presence of autocorrelation in the model. So to remove autocorrelation, I will add some additional variable in the model. You can also convert your variables in log format, or you can transform your model in logarithmic format to remove autocorrelation. So for that, since there were three variables, independent variables already in the model, now I'll add two additional variables, unemployment and literacy rate. Now again, I'll open these variables as equation. So here you can see the first one is the dependent variable followed by five independent variables. So now I'm running the regression using five independent variables instead of 3 as before and see here is the constant. Now click OK. So these are the results, regression results. Here the Durbin-Watson statistics is now different from the previous one. Now it is 1.63, so which is quite close to 2. But to ensure that there is no autocorrelation, we need to check using Allum-Seville correlation test. So for that, go to View, Residual Diagnostics and Seville Correlation Allum Test. So again here, two legs are included in the model. Click OK. Now here you can see the F statistics probability value is 0.36. So this value is greater than 0.05. So now we can accept our null hypothesis that there is no autocorrelation in the model. So we have successfully removed autocorrelation from the model. So this is how you can successfully remove autocorrelation from your model if there is presence of any kind of autocorrelation. I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching.